Hello, friends. Welcome to Suni Art. This is Suni. Hello, 大家好，欢迎来到 Suni Art. This is Suni. So, 今天呢，想跟大家分享呢，就是这件非常简单的作品。So today I'm going to share with you this very very simple project, a notebook decoupage. 就是这个记事本拼贴，就是拼贴在记事本。我用的有棉纸，有用的这个是餐巾纸，然后有那个拼贴专用纸，还有我的那个绢印蕾丝型染板。So here I use the decoupage tissue and the decoupage paper and also Suni Art's silk stencil, a lace silk stencil. So let's start now. 我们现在来开始吧。这个记事本呢，其实是那个硬纸皮的。 This one is a hardcover notebook. Okay, you can use any notebook that you have. 你可以用任何你有的那个记事本。如果你的记事本呢是塑料的，或者是那个仿皮革的，那么呢你就先要涂一层的那个万用底剂。涂了万用底剂呢，你才可以上色。So if your notebook is in PU leather or in plastic surface, you have to apply a layer of sealer first before you base coat, or else the paint is not stick, cannot stick well. 不然的话呢，颜色呢它是不会附着的 ，OK， 不会粘得很好。所以呢，现在呢我们就来涂一层白色的亚克力颜料。So I will apply a layer of soft white acrylic paint on the whole surface, 就是整个把它涂满，就是这样子。Just apply.On the whole surface. So, if you want it to be opaque, look very nicely, then you need to apply two layers. 如果要它，涂的非常饱和呢，就是要涂两层，吹干了再涂一层，不需要打磨。No need to sand. So, like this, one layer, blow dry, then do another layer, make it opaque. That's all. Okay, this is after two layers of acrylic paint and already blow dry. 这个是涂了两层的亚克力颜料，然后也是吹干了。然后呢，我们就要先拼贴这个底纸。Then we need to apply, we have decoupage this tissue first. Okay, 这个是餐巾纸哦。所以呢，今天我选了这一张。Today I choose this piece. So you, as you know, tissue have three layers. 餐巾纸一共有三层，把这两层白色的把它撕掉。So have to tell these two white color. We need only this one with the flower. 我们只要有硬化的这一面，先把它这样撕出来。然后呢，因为我是整张粘嘛，所以整张粘的时候呢，我一般上呢都很喜欢用这个多媒材的亚克力，多媒材的那个拼贴胶。So because I'm going to glue the whole piece, so when I glue whole piece, usually I use this one, mixed media decoupage glue. So I'm going to use this one.So, apply the whole surface, apply the glue on the whole surface, but no need to be very thick. Just enough will do, but not too thin also. 不需要很厚啊，但是也不是太薄，就是足够的，整个表面都有涂到。Make sure the whole surface you apply all the glue. And make sure your finger is not sticky, or else later will stick on the tissue and your tissue might tear.然后呢，也是要注意哦，不要你的手指不要沾到那个胶，然后太粘了，过后你不小心你会把你那个餐巾纸也会给你撕粘上来了，就粘在你的手指上，就是这样子足够就可以了。Just like that, okay. Then blow dry. 然后这个胶呢，一定要吹干，吹干了呢，它才会有粘性。不干的话呢，它一般上不粘。Have to blow dry. If not blow dry, you see it's not sticky. Okay. 先把它吹干。吹干了我们才粘。 Blow dry first. Okay, how long you blow it doesn't matter, okay? 要吹多久呢都没有关系，10秒、20秒、30秒is 都可以。 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds is fine, okay? As long as you blow dry, it will be sticky, okay? And also how long you dry also depends on the weather at your place. 然后呢，其实要吹几久呢，也是取决于你当时你在你的地方的那个温度啦。有些地方蛮热的话呢，它可能一下子它就干了，它就会有黏黏了，只要黏黏就可以了。As long as you feel it a bit sticky, then means you blow enough. Then just put on the tissue. Okay, you see the tissue. Make sure that I will I will look carefully here and here, daily here must be daily, here must be daily. Or else you simply put like that, maybe when you lift up, the tissue is another side. 所以呢 你这里呢和这里一定要对准，不然你随便这样子放的时候，可能你拿上来之后可能是歪的。所以你一定要有两个地方可以给你是有一个界，有一个参考的地方。So you need two places that as a guideline for you. So this glue is very good, you see. Even though I make mistake, I still can lift it up and do not tear the tissue. 它很好的地方呢，就是我做错了的地方呢，我还可以慢慢把它撕上来，但是我也不会撕烂那个餐巾纸。You see, I still can lift like this. Okay, you see, I still can lift like that. Okay, 然后呢，就轻轻的 ，very gently from one side.To another side, 轻轻的，轻轻的推，然后它才没有皱纹。So push it from one side to the other side, 从一边推去另外一边，这样子呢，它才不会有气泡，才不会有皱褶。Then will not have the wrinkles and bubble. Must be from one side to the other side. Okay, you see, very smooth and very smooth.And no wrinkle, 你看这样子呢就没有完全没有皱褶。You see, no wrinkles, no bubble at all. Very simple. Then after that, this one because maybe accidentally there, I can color it back with black color. 这个没有关系。等一下呢，我们可以用那个拼贴纸盖着。Here we can cover with the decoupage paper. Also, no worries. So now we need to use a scraper and a plastic sheet.然后我们再用那个刮板，还有一张这个塑料袋呢，在上面刮一下，可以大力刮。You can add some pressure, can press slightly harder, so that it will be more smooth. 然后呢，它才会更加的服帖。然后那些你知道，餐巾纸有些地方它有一些印花，它会浮上来一些印，那个呢也可以刮平。You know the tissue, some of the part they have the, you know they have some texture.So if you scratch like this, I mean you use the scraper, it will also flatten the texture. Just like that. Then you can feel it is very, very smooth. You see, very smooth without a single wrinkle. 你可以看到完全一个皱褶都没有，是非常的服帖的。这里也是一样。So here is the same. Just put the glue, then glue down. 然后这里也是一样啊，就是放拼贴胶，吹干，然后再粘下去就可以了。所以呢，我就接续咯。So I continue. Now I'm gluing another side. When you see like wrinkle, have wrinkle like this. 那我现在是铺另外一边。如果你觉得哎这边有皱褶，不喜欢，你可以先把它慢慢撕上来。You can lift up slowly and you'll do again. Spread it again slowly. Okay, from one side to the other side. 如果你觉得它有皱纹的，你就慢慢轻轻的把它撕上来。就还是一样，从一边往外推 ，so push out. Then after that, using also the scraper with the plastic, 还是一样哦，就是用那个刮板，大力一点哦，把那个它原本有的一个花纹呢，把它压掉。Okay, every single part you have to scrape nicely. 每一寸的地方呢，都一定要刮，这样子呢，它就会非常的平滑，然后没有皱褶。Each inch of the place, you have to make sure you really scrape well, so that it will be very smooth and no wrinkle and bubble. 然后呢，它就完全的不会有那个气泡，然后也没有皱褶。OK, 然后这样子了过后呢，我们要把多余的那个纸呢把它剪掉。 Then the extra tissue we have to cut it out. I will use a scissor, easier for me. 然后我就用剪刀跟着把它剪出来，我觉得这样子比较容易，就不要用那个指甲戳。指甲戳呢它会弄得它毛毛的，我不喜欢，因为这个它就会可能会撕烂。And I don't, in this project, I don't use the nail file because the nail file will leave some white color and also might spoil the tissue. So in this project, I don't use the nail file. Nail file usually we can apply in using on the wood piece. 对，指甲戳呢，一般上我们可以用在那个木器的作品上 ，like that. Okay.Then all the extra, if not glue well, you still can put back the glue. 然后有多出来的餐巾纸没有粘好的地方呢，你也是可以放那个拼贴胶把它粘回去。 Just cut out the extra tissue. Then done. 这样子就 OK 了。然后如果边边没有，你就要检查一下，边边没有贴好的地方呢，就要放回拼贴胶。Then you have to check if the edges that not glue well, you can put back like that, put back the glue like this way. OK, 就这样子把胶水铺回去。OK, so check first before we do the next step. 一定要先检查一下哦，你还没有做下一个步骤之前呢，一定要检查有没有粘得好好，尤其是边边 especially the edges. So you have to check well, before we do the next step. Have to check whether you, especially the edges, have to, really glue well. OK, 所以你就我觉得 OK 了。 Like for example, I found that, OK, glues quite well already. So now what we need to do, we need to varnish three layers, because this is a paper and this is tissue. It really absorbs a lot of the paint, a lot of the varnish. That's why I need to varnish at least three layers to see no shining. 然后呢，我们最少要涂三层的这个平光保护剂。为什么要三层呢？因为这个是纸嘛，我们的素材又是纸的，然后这个餐巾纸又是纸，它很容易吸那个颜料和我们的那个保护剂，所以呢，一两层呢，其实它基本上你不会看到它亮亮的，没有达到很好的保护效果。所以为什么我一定要涂三层 ？So if only one or two layers, it cannot reach a very good protection. So that's why I need to apply three layers, at least three layers on this before I do the decoupage.在我还没有要做拼贴之前，我一定要确保它保护得非常好，所以至少三层。 So like this is one layer, blow dry, then another layer, blow dry another layer. After the first layer, I will also use the scraper. I will show you later. 然后我先把它吹干，吹干了过后呢，我还是要用刮板把它刮一下，让它更平滑。 OK, so blow dry. Make sure blow very dry before you use the scraper. 你一定要确保吹得非常干，然后冷却了过后呢，才可以用那个刮板。 You have to make sure you blow very very dry. The surface have to blow very dry and also cool down first, then use the scraper. Or else when you use the scraper with the plastic, the tissue might stick on the plastic. 如果呢吹得不干或者是没有冷却足够，然后呢，那个餐巾纸其实它会粘在这个塑料，就会给你撕烂。Then you will peel it off. OK, be very careful. Now blow dry first. 现在先吹干。Oh, 你看 ，this one already blow very dry and already cool down. So have to use a scraper again. 然后这个吹了很干哦，而且呢也已经是冷却了。然后我就再用刮板再刮一下。OK, 然后你可以看到它非常非常的平了，会更加的平滑。但是你一定要确保你要做这个动作之前呢，你的这个素材呢一定要吹得很干。 So but when you do this one, when you do this scraping, you have to really make sure blow very dry. You see here, not dry, so dry yet. That's why you see I will tear this one up. 所以这个应该是不干，你可以摸一下这里，我已经觉得它很干了，但是它还是不干。I already feel it is very dry, but it's still not dry yet. That's why you see I will tear this one out. So be very careful. 我感觉它很干了，但是它好像还没有干透。所以呢，你看就会有这样子的问题出现，所以你们要小心注意了。So you must be very careful. Must really pay attention, okay?过后呢，我们要再做第二层。 So we will do a second layer. Then the second layer, if you want to use a scraper or you don't want to use a scraper, is totally up to you. 第二层呢，你要不要再用那个刮板呢？这个是自由你喜欢的，你觉得你要让它更加的平滑，你还是可以用的。 So if you feel that you want it to be more flat and more smooth without the wrinkle at all, then you can still use it, but have to make sure blow it very dry.当然你一定要确保要吹得很干，不要好像我这样子。因为呢刚才呢我是这样子吹的， because just now I blow it dry like this, I put a mug and my hair dryer, so I just, it's just face only, the head, the actually the air is only here, that's why here not dry. 所以我刚才是懒惰吧， because I'm lazy, so 我是这样子放在一个杯子里面，让我的那个吹风机这样子吹，所以它只是吹来这里，这里其实它是没有吹到的，所以你要注意咯。 So you must be careful, yeah? Second layer blow dry already, make sure very dry already, so you still can use a scraper. 去了第二层呢，你觉得它已经很干了呢，你还是可以再用刮板刮一下，让它更加的平滑。So to make sure more smooth and totally no wrinkles and bubble. Then apply another layer, 然后呢，我们再涂第三层。第三层吹干了过后呢，我们就要来做那个坚硬的新染板。After third time, varnish, then we will do the stencil, okay? So I have to blow dry, I apply first, then blow dry, then we continue.Okay, then now I'm going to use this stencil, Lay Stencil 0015, number 15. I will use this piece to do the lace at the side. 然后呢，我就用这个15号的型染板呢，我就要做这个边。然后我不想它的颜色呢太过白，所以呢，我就用这个绢印剂，一定要用绢印剂哦。Then because I don't want it to look like very bright and white color, this one is too bright.So I will mix the stencil paste with the vanilla color, 4 paint and 1 paste. 所以呢，这个是四对一。You can go to the description section. I will send the link. The link is very clear that to teach you step by step how to use the silk stencil with the paste. 所以呢，你要点击进入那个描述栏，描述栏里面呢，我会发那个链接给你们去看一下，要如何使用这个绢印剂跟那个颜料一起。所以呢，描述栏呢，很多人都不会使用 ，a lot of friends don't know how to use the description, how to go into the description section. So here, you see, for example, 这个就是那个。就是那个描述栏咯，比如说这个视频来 ，for example this tutorial。See, you will see a arrow here. 你会看到这里有一个那个三角形，对不对？会没有看到那个三角形的一个这个键，按进去呢，你就其实就看到全部我写的全部需要的材料和全部这个作品所需要用到的东西。So you just click in, then you will see all the material that I needed to use for this project. Everything very clear.全部都很清楚，你就进描述栏看一下就好了。So just click into the description section, okay? So this one is the paste that I make that day. So because the leftover I put into the palette, wet palette. 这个是我那天做的，然后剩下的呢，我就把它放去了我这个保湿盒里面。所以呢，我就想要现在就直接把保湿盒里面的那个颜料呢，把它刮出来，直接做在这里。So because here I was going to wrap down.So you can do together, to the side. So you leave leave some space for the side. 所以呢，你要留一点点去旁边。这里呢，跟着上面 here, follow the top. Okay, so just leave a little bit for the side here. 所以边边呢要留一点哦，因为我要整个挂下去嘛。就大概你要对准这里。So here must be daily, then you will know that it's straight. Okay.Then use the silicone scraper, 然后就用这个细胶的刮板把它全部刮上来。Then take the base and scrape up, just put on. It's a very simple actually. 其实是蛮简单的，就是这个新染板也很容易清洗。And also this sensor is very easy to clean. It's very easy to clean with normal water, no need to use special soap.用普通的清水就可以很简单的、很容易的把它清理掉了，也不需要用什么特别的那个清洗液。No need special soap to clean this one. But you have to wash it immediately you use. 你需要呢，一用了呢就要马上把它清洗，不然的话呢，过后就会比较难清理。Or else later, you have to clean it immediately. Or else later will be a bit hard to clean. Here, fold down. 这里呢，把它压下来，还是一样的。So it's the same. So maybe some part is not so perfect, but it's okay lah.有一些地方呢可能不会很完美哦，但是没有关系啦。然后我们来看一下 ，Let's have a look， 来看一看。嗯 ，See very nice lace， 看到吗？就是很美的那个 那个蕾丝，然后就把它吹干 ，then blow dry。Okay, now we need to apply two layers of the varnish to protect this stencil, lace stencil. 所以呢，现在我们要上两层的保护剂，来保护那个我们已经做好的蕾丝，也是用回这个平光的。Also same using this one. Do not mix with water. 不需要加水，但是一定要确保吹得很干哦，不然的话哦，这个如果不干的话呢，这个颜料呢会一定会给我们拉掉。If not dry enough, this color will paint away. Okay, so make sure that really blow very dry. 所以一定要确保吹得很干。这样子过后呢，吹干，再来涂多一层。So second layer, after second layer, we can start decoupage already. So decoupage is just a very normal method.Just normal simple decoupage, OK? 然后呢，拼贴就很简单啦，就是我们平时一般的拼贴的技法就可以了。然后就当然你要先铺排啦。So we need to plan first. Make sure is it dry? Yes, quite dry already. 一定要确保很干哦。然后呢，我用的这张拼贴纸呢是 KAD 二十一号 ，and this decoupage paper I'm using is KAD 21, but you can use any decoupage paper that you have. 当然，你可以用任何你有的那个拼贴纸的，你任何你有的纸都可以 ，OK? 没有一个，总之你喜欢的图形都可以 ，use any image that you like，OK?So the paper I already pre-cut, and now you have to arrange where how you want to the paper look like. 所以你现在呢就要大概的去设计一下你的图纸了，你要如何设计？然后呢，因为我们这个不是整张粘的嘛，我就会用普通的拼贴胶。And because this one we are not going to glue the whole piece part by part, I will use a normal decoupage glue. Don't use the mixed media glue because mixed media glue is very hard to clean. 因为呢，这个多媒材拼贴胶它很粘哦，然后会非常难的清理，所以呢，我就会选普通的拼贴胶就好了。所以我们就大概来铺排一下。So we roughly see how you want to design this piece. 所以我们就大概看一下。我可能把两个玫瑰放在下面，一定要有重叠的哦。Always remember you need this paper for like overlapping. Don't always put like this one by one. This one is very well arranged and not natural. 不要一张一张这样子摆，我这样子觉得呢，它就很像太过工整了，然后很不自然。所以呢，我一般会喜欢呢，会有重叠。I like to have overlap. Okay, overlapping.Like this, okay? And then the leaf maybe put at the back. 然后叶子呢放在最后面。所以最后面的地方呢，我们是要先贴。So we need to decoupage the most at the back one. 最后的要先贴。拼贴我觉得很多人都应该没有问题啦。I know a lot of you should be no problem on the decoupage.大概是这样子，所以每一个人的设计都可能会不一样。So everyone's design might not be the same, but it's fine. Okay, this one I also can put like here because here more white, you can see my key more. 这边比较多白色，可能你就可以看得到我的那个钥匙比较多。Like that maybe, okay? 这样子也 okay. Like this also can. Okay, so I have to glue this one first. 所以我就要先。粘这个叶子，笔呢不要太湿 ，this one must be dry. So I will glue from the back. 我会从下面先贴一个。So fix the position of the first part first. 先这个先定位，一个定位了就比较简单。After you fix the position of the first one, then the rest will be easy. Okay.Follow the position, follow the direction, 跟着它的那个它的形铺下去。Okay, then use a scraper and the plastic, 然后就这样子刮。 然后多余的胶水呢一定要把它清掉。 And the extra glue have to clean, must clean the extra glue. You can use a wet tissue or you can use a damp cloth. 你可以用湿布或者是湿纸巾把多余的胶水呢一定要把它清掉。 Clean, clean out, 往外擦，然后吹干， then blow dry, then only continue the second one, second decoupage.一定要吹干，因为有重叠，然后我们才可以做第二层。Then only we can do the second layer， 才可以做第二层。都大概看一下 ，so roughly like this， yeah， okay， like this， this one can put straight， up to you， then this one standard， okay， 然后我就来贴这一张。Then now this piece。It's the same, it's very simple. You can watch a lot of my video doing the same technique. Decoupage is the same. 其实你可以在很多我的视频都会看到这个拼贴的那个方式是一样的。OK. 然后呢一定要把它清干净多余的那个拼贴胶。所以为什么我们刚才一定要上保护剂。That's why we need to apply the varnish because Now it's easy to clean， 所以呢现在就比较容易清理。如果你有涂了拼贴胶呢，你有打了亮光保护剂呢，你就不会损坏下面的地方。Because after you apply the varnish, you won't spoil the base, you won't hurt the base, okay？ 你 see, just layer by layer， 就是一层一层慢慢的叠上去。So maybe like this， 这个大概是这样子。Don't apply. You see this one is not enough glue. Now we can glue back. 这里不够拼贴胶，先把它粘回去。我要讲的是，不要把那个拼贴胶贴在纸的后面。Don't apply the glue here. It's very difficult for you to glue down later. So I always do put the glue on the surface. 我每次呢都是把拼贴胶呢涂在素材上，而不是涂在纸的背面。不然的话呢，这样子是非常非常难。非常难拼贴的。Like that. Then blow dry. Then just continue the rest. 然后又接续其他的就完成了。OK, 然后我就再接续咯。Just continue.Continue and continue， 就接续就好了。我纸都帮我飞去。I don't know where the paper fly. Don't know where it fly. Really never mind. Just continue, okay? You see, very fast. We complete a very simple notebook and very fast and very nice and very personal, very personalized. I mean, you can make a very different notebook that nobody has. Okay? 你也可以做一本，你看，很快我们就完成了一本记事本，然后是没有人有的，都是你的设计。Okay? 是独一无二的。然后先把它吹很干。So after blow very dry, apply the matte varnish again two layers. 然后do not add water. 吹了很干过后呢，就涂两层的这个平光保护剂，不要加水。Don't add water, just two layers, because the water will dilute the varnish and make it very dilute. 因为那个水呢会稀释这个会稀释这个亮光保护剂，然后呢怕那个水也会渗透到纸张，会不好看。And also afraid that water might penetrate into the paper, it might make the paper become transparent. After two layers, if you want it to be more shining, you can change the glossy varnish. If you don't want to use the glossy varnish, then you can keep going using the same varnish, but now you can add water after two layers. 两层过后呢，如果你想你的作品更加的亮光呢，你可以用那个亮光保护剂，亮光的，不是平光的。如果你觉得你不要那个亮光的，你就可以两层了，这样子两层了过后呢，你可以用回相同的保护剂，但是你可以加水，就大概要涂大概三层四层就达到很好的保护效果。 layers of this one matte, then I can add the glossy. 我就喜欢呢，涂了两层平光，我就涂两层的亮光。Then I like to apply two layer matte, then another two or three layers of the glossy. I want it to be more protective. So how many layers is up to you, but at least total three to four layers. Okay, after you complete everything.OK， 所以呢，多少层呢是自由随性的，但是呢，至少呢要涂三或四层就达到很好的保护效果。然后不要忘记边边也是要哦 ，Don't forget the edges have to varnish also. So blow dry then completed already. Then 吹干呢就已经完全完成了，就是很简单。You can see the project is, you see, very shining and look very flat, no wrinkles, very nice project. Hope you like today's project. 所以你看呢，它就完全是你看很平，很亮光，然后没有皱褶，完全是很平滑的。希望你喜欢今天的作品，欢迎分享。Hope you can share with your friend. Hope you give me a like. 也希望你给我一个赞哦，感恩收看，谢谢。Thank you for watching. Bye.